a good time. Put a smile on your face, yeah. KBKM and Elation Radio. Even brighten your day and help you through the night. Bring you good music. KBKM and Elation Radio. And here's your host.
Check the way I walk. Been set free, cause my father paid the cost. No, I'm not perfect. God just forgave me. Got a new swag, praising Christ like I'm crazy. This my Christ swag, yeah. My Christ swag, yeah. Uh-huh. This my Christ swag.
Okay.
My Christ swag, yeah. This my Christ swag,
yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Uh-huh.
This my Christ swag. My Christ swag, yeah.
Yeah, I'm from the streets. South of the arch, man. Where I used to drink, roll up, and used to spark, man. Now I got my head straight, shining like a million bucks. Christ elevated me, going past the ceiling, bruh. St. Louis 50, God Squad t-shirt. Homie, how you doing? Pleased to meet you, this my rebirth. Addicted to the word, it's pumping through my artery. Faith on the meal, the swag is a part of me. Now my glow bright. Soul's been redeemed, covered in the blood, no shower cause I'm clean, done playing games, rid of the Xbox, almost flatline, but Christ made my chest pop, walked on the edge, the devil made me wobble, Jesus took the wheel, fast forward full throttle, still in the hood, got that street slang, mixed with the spirit, it's a G thing.
Keep high talk, check the way I walk. Been set free, cause my father paid the cost. No, I'm not perfect, God just forgave me. Got a new swag, praising Christ like I'm crazy. This my Christ swag,
yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Uh-huh.
This my Christ swag,
okay. Yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
God Squad,
this my Christ swag, yeah. My Christ swag, yeah. This my Christ swag,
Cartier.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Look. My whole style come from Christ,
yeah.
So own it? No sir, you can't put a price. Like white on rice, I got his blood on me. To be honest, I just care about my guy, homie. And if I'm only living for him, it don't really even matter what y'all think of me. Opinions, you can let them be. I'm killing it, I let them see. The old me is gone. Keep the demons out my heart, then Christ found a home. No more Patron or Nitrous. I might just give God a praise with my best. He's highest. Glory in here. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Put my trust in the Lord. I ain't having no fear. No, I don't have a care. Besides pleasing my Father. To tell any hater you see, man, don't even bother, cause Jesus is my medicine. I ain't never hurting, catching waves of his glory, man. I'm Christ swag surfing.
Yeah. I talk, check the way I walk. Been set free, cause my father paid the cost. No, I'm not perfect, God just forgave me. Got a new swag, praising Christ like I'm crazy. This my Christ swag,
yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Uh-huh.
This my Christ swag,
okay.
My Christ swag, yeah. This my Christ swag,
yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Uh-huh.
This my Christ swag.
God Squad.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Okay, I get it from my father.
Uh-huh.
Head to toe swinging on that word, that's a motto.
Yeah.
Used to be a up or down flipper like the Lido.
Uh-huh.
Roll with Big Frank and ST, old squad though. Now I'm aiming at the world with that blessed scope.
Yeah.
Hard repetition, stay flexing, holy rollers know. When you see that light shine, this ain't baby dough. He ain't got a VVS on him, what a freak show. But I'm close with my father though. I ain't Leroy, but the boy got a lot of glow. Took a whole lot of laying out to kill his ego. Missing my whole purpose like Shaq with them free throws. If you rapping vain, can't edify the people. Swag on 100, gaining speed, adios flow. And I'm top flow, reaching for his glory. You think I got some swag? Christ the one that poured it on me.
Check the way I walk. Been set free, cause my father paid the cost. No, I'm not perfect, God just forgave me. Got a new swag, praising Christ like I'm crazy. This my Christ swag,
yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Uh-huh.
This my Christ swag,
okay.
My Christ swag, yeah. This my Christ swag,
yeah.
My Christ swag, yeah.
Uh-huh.
This my Christ swag. My Christ swag, yeah.
Boom, boom. Good evening, everybody. Welcome back. It's been another fabulous week. Thank you, Sister Kim. Welcome, everybody, to Relation Radio. This is Minister Cedric on the Litany's Pursuit Radio. Man, I've had a great, great week. I've had a lot on my mind today. Yeah, March 19th, 2021. A lot on my mind today. A lot going on in the world. Just an immense amount of things happening. We if you've been looking at the news at all, you know, we still got the saga, the stain left over from the last presidency. We still have the issues that we're dealing with COVID and all the problems that have been caused by this virus. We got issues with people not wanting to take the virus, issues with education. I mean, we just got a bazillion, it seems like, issues out here today. But I want to tell y'all, it's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. So I ain't want to talk about none of that. I ain't want to talk about none of that at all. All I want to talk about today, because I was sitting back, and this has been a very reflective day for me. My day, I've spent a little bit of time with myself today. Looking over how I approach my day, how I lay out my plans for the day, how I handle my responsibilities, how I handle conflict, how I show people that I appreciate them or they are appreciated. It's been one of those days. And in this day, I was pushed back because I was told by somebody, here it is. They were talking to me about pride. And I was like, what? And they called me a lot of, well, they used several different adjectives to describe me, which I didn't feel that they were fair, but I accepted what they said. And it just took me to Proverbs 11 and 2. And it says, when pride comes, then comes dishonor, but with the humble is wisdom. Yeah, if anybody knows me, I'm not all that humble, but I can be humble at times, right? But so today, I kind of wanted to jump in. I wanted to talk a little bit about pride, and not just pride. I want specifically, you know, some of the good things and some of the bad things about pride. Because as a young man, I was pride wasn't a bad word in my household. Pride wasn't a bad word with what we did. So. I guess I just kind of wanted to talk about that today. The good, the bad, and the ugly thing about pride. So with that being said, I want to bring on my two co-hosts. I have Pastor Terry. Pastor Terry, you on with us? And then I have...
Yes, sir. How you doing?
I'm doing good. You sound like you're having a great day also. And on
it's been one of
on
those.
The other side... It's been one of those. Okay, you're going to get a chance to tell us about one of those days. How about that? On the other side, I have my brother, a good friend of mine, Jason Walter. Jason, you on with us?
What's up,
right
my man?
Now?
How we doing today?
Doing all right. Welcome,
good,
gentlemen.
Good.
Oh, man, that's how I love it. I was just sitting back, and this whole pride thing came to me. I had a conversation with a friend of mine. And this whole pride thing came to me. And, man, I want to ask you, like, is it wrong to take pride in things? Is pride such a bad thing? Now, I know I use the Bible scripture, but I just want to know, is pride such a bad thing?
When I think about, like, when you say take pride in something, you know, I take pride in my yard. You know, and that's okay. I mean, you put in the work, you're reaping the benefits, you know, and you're seeing how your hard work is paid off. So it's okay to take pride in things like that, like your yard, you know, how clean your car is, or, you know. But when it becomes a point where you just say, you know something, this, you know, this is all about me. This is about my satisfaction, you know, my admired qualities or my, what's the word I'm looking for? I don't need nothing else. You know, I got all I need or whatever, and you lift yourself up like that, that's when it becomes an issue, you know?
But explain, lift yourself up like that. That's where I got lost.
Or put at your detriment, should I say. When you allow, you want to keep this image up, should I say, and you don't want people to think bad of you. Because I just had this conversation like about an hour ago with somebody, and it's kind of funny that we're having a conversation. And I said, that's the reason why I was laughing, because I had this conversation, and I told this person, I said, look, I said, you're sitting on, I said, do you need, what do you need? And then they got real quiet, and I said, look, don't sit over there hungry, or you're hungry, you need money, or you need whatever. And you know that there's people around you that are willing to help you, but you're so concerned about how they're going to view you or what they're going to think. You know, your pride, your way you want to keep that image up is going to have you broke, busted, and disgusted. You know, and then, you know, they got quiet. And the next thing you know, I said, look, I'm going to say it one more time. Do you need anything? And this is not about putting your business out there, making you look bad. Then the very first thing they says, well, I'm not poor. I said, this has nothing about you, another idea about you being poor. This has if you have a need. And so they finally told me what their need was. I said, okay. Do you need, okay, and I said, well, how much do you need or what do you need? And they told me. I said, okay, we'll take care of that. I said, it's a loan. I said, but you can pay it back at your leisure. So it's not one of those type of things where we're going to be asking for it back anytime soon. But I'm just saying is that I had to really put that to this individual. Like, you know something, you're going to be sitting over there hungry and alone and cold, probably with no heat or nothing, all because of pride, because you're so concerned about how other people are going to view you.
Ain't that beautiful? Ain't that beautiful?
And you know, that is definitely something that, wow, yeah, some of us, we get caught up in that. We get caught up. But what about you, Jason? What do you say about pride? How does that work with you?
So as we were talking, I kind of looked up the definition of pride, and I think the second definition, it says consciousness of one's own mm-hmm. identity. And I think that definition of pride is what we kind of refer to, because I think when you become conscious of your own identity, to Terry's mm-hmm. point, to the detriment of others, that's when we start mm-hmm. seeing how pride can become destructive, right? I have this mm-hmm. I have this thing that I consider dignity for myself, but in trying to maintain that and be aware of that, I now violate somebody else. You know, I don't allow myself to operate maybe in a truthful fashion, you know. So I think, you know, pride, I don't think it's a bad thing to, you know, to have a pleasure or satisfaction to say, hey, I did a good job, you know. But it's when that sense of your own self, to kind of what to Terry's point, starts to become detrimental in your interaction with other people, right? I'm so proud of this activity that I don't allow myself to, like Terry said, ask for help because, you know, I don't want to be seen somewhere else. You know, I'm so proud of this activity or this image or something that I'll lie, you know, I'll cheat, I'll do whatever it takes just to maintain that sense. So I think that's when we talk about pride, you know, I don't think it's a bad thing to have, but just like everything else, it's the overuse of that situation that makes it detrimental.
Wow. Okay. I, y'all know what? I'm almost quiet on it. But so we're talking about these things about pride, but is it okay for me? Because like, if, and I'm only talking first person because I'm just talking about myself. But when you see a person who carries him or herself, let's look at their clothing. Let's look at their aesthetics. Let's look at their entire appearance here. is it a bad thing to have pride or take pride in the way you look, the way you physically look, the way you carry yourself?
No, there's nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. But here's the problem comes. Is when the problem comes is when that becomes your main focus and you lose sight of anything else. When that becomes, when you so get caught up on, don't I look good? Don't I look good? And that's your whole focus is just about you just looking good and not, and it becomes so self-centered and so point to the point to where you don't take into consideration anything else beyond just you. Then that becomes an issue. You know, I just want to finish your statement. But I guess what I'm saying is like, I've seen Cedric. I mean, it's not to blow any smoke or anything, but this is really, I've seen him wear a suit to church or something and then turn around with that same suit on and them same nice dress shoes, change attire. He's helped people. You know what I'm saying? So he didn't allow him looking good in that suit to keep him from being able to help somebody. See, when you begin to, I look darn good, I ain't going to get out there and help this person. It's in the rain and change their tire. Then that becomes a problem. That starts becoming a problem. Does that make sense?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, so, and I, Jason?
Yeah, I would say along that point, I think, you know, when you talk about like pride, like you, like the example you gave, Cedric, I look good. Well, when you say like that person don't look good as me, and that in the elevation of yourself, you start pushing other people down. I think that's another way pride becomes disruptive. And like to Terry's point, I think if it interferes with the successful interaction with another person, then we got to ask ourselves: is that pride really, really productive? Right? Is that pride really something we should have? Right? You know. So you know, it's really easy to say, well, it's okay for me to think I look good. Now, I don't think that's a problem. But because you think you look good, now you start looking down on other people for whatever they look like, you know, that's when I think that pride becomes detrimental.
See, it is funny because when this person told me that, immediately my mind went where exactly what we're talking about. In my mind, though my words, I didn't utter these words. In my mind, I was thinking, you know, maybe I'm this horrible thing. But I started thinking of the dark side. But then I started thinking because as you guys know, from a young age, I was being groomed to be a soldier from a very young age. And pride, we talked about pride actually in a very good way. There are some positive things about pride. And those were the things after, you know, this phone call, I was like, wow, you know, I can, you, because I started thinking, if you compliment someone so much that they start to believe the hype, then yeah, they become arrogant, they become all these things. But I also believe it can do wonders for a person's mental health to pay them a compliment or to recognize that they're doing a good job. So I think one of the things for me, one of the things I learned on the positive side of pride, and you guys can share some of yours, but on the positive side. What I learned about pride was, and this is, and Terry, this is one thing, and Jason, I see you work at this. And it befuddles me how meticulous you guys are. Is that you set standards for yourself high? You hold high standards for yourself, and I think that pride. If you have enough pride, like you were just saying, Terry, about your yard, if you take enough pride in doing something, you may as well do it right. And if you get a compliment from somebody, great. But if you don't, great. And so I think that there's some positive aspects of pride that we miss. And for me, I think one of the positive
outcomes to having a little bit of pride in your work is that you do have a higher standard. And I think, how can we teach our young people today? Again, all of our examples initially weren't the best examples of pride, but how can we teach some of our younger people today that it's okay and teach them to have pride, as my example was appearances?
I think you hit on it. I think you know, when we talk about pride, like I mentioned earlier, I don't think pride in and of itself is a bad thing. It's when that pride becomes so big that if it starts to, you know, affect, you know, how you treat people, how you act toward people, how you, you know, interact with people, you know. And I think with our kids, we've got to let them know, like I always tell my kids the same thing, you know, God made you beautiful and special, right? And, you know, you don't walk around thinking that you're a loser, thinking that there's something wrong with you. Walk around knowing that you're special and you're beautiful. And, you know, take pride in that. Take pride in what God has done and how he's made you, you know. And you know, and be realistic, you know. Don't think that you're just like, I can't do anything wrong. But, you know, don't, you know, it's finding that delicate balance, right, where you're not so self-deprecating that you just think you're worthless and you're near nobody, but you're not so egotistical that you think that you're everybody and you're everything, you know. And it's finding that delicate balance. And I think, you know, it's helping those kids kind of find that ground, because they've got so many things reminding them and telling them that they're lesser than. And to be real honest, if you want to talk about, you know, children, you know, especially children in the Black community, they've got so many things telling them that they're lesser than, you know. So we have to kind of remind them that, no, you're not, you know. You are special. You are great, you know. And forget about what culture and society tells you, you know. Let me help you learn that for yourself.
And I mean, like, okay, check this out. Another thing that I found was, and I wouldn't say detrimental, but by the time I got to high school, I was probably wearing my JROTC uniform to school. We normally wore it one day a week. I started out 2 days a week, and then I was up to 3, sometimes 4 days a week, because I was going to different high schools, competing in different competitions, wearing it just for the fun of it, to be honest. I didn't have to buy school clothes, right? But it helped me to develop, again, a sense of pride in my appearance. But what happened when my appearance was good? Another thing for me about pride, another good thing was people, when they did pay me those compliments, my attitude changed. When people came against me with negativity, when people said something that was meant to hurt me, well, because I had been trained to have a sense of pride in who I am and what I am. Y'all know how it is. When you leave the house, our parents told us, "Don't go out there acting a fool, because you ain't representing you. You represent this family. You represent this house. You representing this name." Y'all know what I'm saying? And so another great thing that came from having a sense of pride and who I was was that it allowed me to tell people to back off with that negativity without getting upset, without getting into fight. And what it did was it made me resilient, right? Because those attacks, they didn't work on me anymore. It just didn't work on Cedric the way that it worked on some of my other friends. Like, they get mad. Like, my favorite thing to do to people when we were in a small circle and they got on my nerves, some of my closer friends, I would always say, "Your mama," right? I knew it would upset them. But here's the big deal to me. I tried to do it in secret. Now, I was wrong. There's two left shoes, don't get me wrong. But my thing was, I didn't want to be out fighting. I didn't want to be always cutting up and talking real loud. You know, we're friends, you know, we just whispered each other kind of thing in the lunchroom. Everybody didn't know what we were talking about. But the thing was, I had too much self-respect to
act like I saw a lot of my other friends acting, and it kind of made me nervous. So, personally, I'm trying to pull out the good things about pride. I mean, can you think of anything great about having pride?
Now, Siri, to your point, I think when you talk about that positive self-esteem that sometimes that pride gives you, I think it is important. But I think and what needs to happen is that stuff has to be internalized. It has to go beneath just the surface, right? People telling you, hey, Siri, you look good in that uniform is great to hear, but until you internalize it, unfortunately, just if you leave it on that surface level, then when someone tells you look bad in that suit, then you're going to be like, oh, okay, right? But I think for your point, you know, what you demonstrated is not only did you hear those compliments, but you started to internalize them and let them shape what you thought of yourself. So, I think pride is a great thing. And then having a sense of, you know, hey, this is how I carry myself. Like for me in my personal life, my sense of pride comes with my integrity. And I've been in many situations where it's okay to cut this corner. It's okay to shave a little bit off or add a little bit extra, right? That's what everybody does. Jason, no, don't worry about it. And everybody's okay with it. But my sense of pride and my integrity doesn't allow me to do that, you know? And, you know, and I think that's helped me with my career. You know, a lot of people will tell you, well, Jason, you may not be the easiest person to get along with, but you're a man of integrity, and I know I can trust you. And that means a lot to me, you know. So,
yeah
there are some positive things that come from being prideful and trying to hold yourself to a high standard and doing that time and time again.
Because I'm just drawing on some – and I'm going back to my high school years simply because of the age, right? Like another one of the things because I said – And I remember doing some inspecting our cadets' uniforms, and one of the signs that a cadet was proud of being a part of our organization was, check this out. One of the good things that came out of having pride in that uniform and what we were trying to teach him is, for me as a senior cadet, was I knew that they cared. I knew that they cared about our organization to the point where they would not be one of the students running the hallway. You know what I'm saying? They took such – and it was something that we tried to instill in them. I know that was instilled in me for the 4 years in high school, but then you took care of business, right? And if we had a cadet who came on Tuesdays when we wore our uniforms and their uniform didn't look very good, right? Well, there's a couple of things. The first thing I would think of is this student doesn't know how to take care of his or her uniform. And then I would say I would look at how they had the breasts and the things that we had to wear on our uniforms. I would look at the placement. I would measure it. And if they didn't take the time to do these precise measurements, I would assume that they didn't care. But I tell you, when you gave them a pat on the back and you said, you know what, this is good, you look great, they started to straighten up. Their uniform was pressed. They were putting them in the cleaners. They were coming in. They were getting the lint off the uniform. Everything, all the insignia was placed precisely where it needed to be. And this was, for me as a cadet, was like, wow. And it made me actually proud to be a part of the organization as well. And so what we did in JROTC was try to instill a level of pride. Why? One of the big reasons for us as cadets is we wanted to create our future leaders. You see, it all came together when I was in high school. That pride is not always a bad thing. I mean, maybe it's not the number one thing, but I think it's the start of something big. And growing up new leaders. I mean, both of you guys played sports, right? I mean, what are some of the good things? What are some of the things that you guys had? The good things that came by you guys being proud to be on the teams you play on? Or how
well, you know, always that commitment and that dedication, right? And it's sometimes that motivating factor. Like you said, I have pride in myself. So instead of me just succumbing to the situation, I'm going to persevere and push through because that pride is going to motivate me to. So it can be used as a motivating force. And playing sports, you know, just kind of being proud on that team, it just gives you an energy to play with. And, you know, and to say, you know, it also gives you a sense of I want to hold up my end, right? I don't want to let these people down because we're all proud of who we are and what we do.
Because I step back and I tell you, I see how people, some of the people today, you know, on the negative side of pride, people are willing to kill for, I'm proud to be this, I'm proud to be that, and they are willing to kill for it. And that's an example, an extreme example, but a very common example in our society today. But sometimes, again, I say pride can be a good thing. Like, I believe that when you're proud about something, when you're proud of your family, what do? You look after your family. You take care of your family. You will go to war for your family. And so when I started thinking about pride, I started thinking about positive things that positive ways that it's influenced me. The examples are limitless, you know, and there are just so many things that we can do or we should be doing. But I go back to the question I asked earlier. How can we help instill this positive side of pride in our young people today? What can we do? Terry, you've been awful quiet. You work in with youth more than anybody I know. Jason, my thought is this, is that if we don't if we don't stand up and take the lead in helping our kids decide what's good and what's bad and showing them and being the example, where are they going to go from here?
Yeah, and you know, for me, I kind of equate pride, you know, with identity. And I think it's so important to instill in our kids, kind of like what you talked about, that sense of, that internal sense of who you are and what you're about. So I've been talking about pride, but I think for me it's almost synonymous with my identity, right? The things that I'm most proud of are the things I identify with the most about me, how I try to internally define myself, right? Not what the world thinks of me, but what I think about myself. So I think as we try to, you know, teach our young people, it's really teaching them a sense of themselves and you know, who they are and what they're about. And not the arrogant, like, hey, I'm a big shot, hey, I'm this, hey, I'm that, but a real good view of, hey, you are somebody, right? And because you're somebody, you know, this is what you do, right? Try to teach the kids that to maintain that sense of identity, you have to do certain things, right? So, like we talked
right,
about, that
how?
Positive use
but,
of pride.
But, yeah, but how? You know,
I think.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I think, you know, when I work with kids and I talk to them about their identity, I talk to them about, like, the things that makes them special, right? One of the things I love to ask kids are, like, what are you good at? Oh, I'm not good at anything. I'm like, ah, come on, man, you got to be good at something. And when you start getting them talking and you start connecting with them, you start allowing them to see, like, man, you're really good at that. Like, I had this one student I was working with, and he had a really bad stutter. And, you know, over time we started talking, and, you know, we started, you know, we just started getting to know him. Well, one day I just had a random conversation, and he saw my car, and he broke down my car, the engine type, and he just started telling me all about so many cars. So I remember that, and then later on I reminded him, I'm like, man, you're really good about cars. You know your stuff. And just, you know, just helping them see that they do have knowledge. They do have abilities and skills. You know, a lot of times with kids, they compare themselves with that kid out there on YouTube doing all those things, making all those likes. And I'm like, well, that's not you. That's not how you've been gifted. That's not how you've been blessed. And really getting them to see the things that they've been blessed with, you know, finding areas that they have been successful in. You know, I know so many kids who can like put a puzzle together in like 35, like in no time at all. And they tell me that I don't have any skills. I'm like, dude, I just watched you put that puzzle together. I can never do that. You mean, what do you mean? That's simple. I'm like, yeah, it's simple for you because you're gifted. Right? So I always try to remind them those little things, you know, because I think they take for granted the things that they've done, and they just think, oh, well, that's nothing. Like, everybody does that. But I try to remind them, like, no, not everybody can do what you did, and that's what makes you special, you know. So I think, you know, if we talk about how to help kids kind of develop that pride, it's just to look at what they're already doing, right, and just remind them, because you're doing that, that's what makes you special.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's amazing. Yeah, I think that's amazing, Jason. I mean, really, and you know, you can do some things that nobody else can do. That's what makes you special, you know, and really taking pride in developing those things that they cannot do, or that they've learned to do, or that they can do that nobody else can do. And I mean, I guess that's one of those things I really, really, when I was working with kids, is really trying to help them to, what's the word I'm looking for? Master their craft, if you will. You know, like I had this one kid that really was a great speaker, and I was like, okay, now here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna work with you on developing and being a master at your craft. So whenever you're called upon, it's not about, oh, you know, I don't know what to say, or I don't know how to do it, I'm nervous. No, you're gonna know how to get up in front. You're gonna be able to get up in front of anybody and be able to share. Uh-huh. Your gift and what you can do that's special. And I mean, and helping them to understand that that's okay. It's okay. You know, because I think for so long in the church is that we have created, we've shown the negative side of taking pride, like you were saying, and some things, and not focusing on helping people develop areas that make them special, you know what I'm saying, and taking pride in those and being able to master those.
Because you guys have said, I mean, a mouthful. And again, as I recall all my days as a young JROTC cadet, all of these things are what we were told. I mean, can you imagine sitting in the class for hours at a time? And I remember one of the things as a freshman, because I had some friends, because I wasn't from a upper middle class family. You know, I spent a lot of time in the lower income, impoverished areas of town. And I'll tell you, man, being in the hood was different. You know, the crowds you run with, it was different. It was just different. And so, can you imagine when I got to high school and they said, you need to be hanging around a different crowd of people. And I'm like, what? This all the people I know. I don't know these other people. And I'm going to tell you something. Having a sense of pride. See, like now let's be honest. Today, pride is man, they can be so confused. They're proud to be in the gang. Some kids. Mm-hmm. They're proud to wear the name brand clothes. They're proud of all these things, but a lot of the things that they're proud of cause them to be selfish, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's incredible to me that when you tell a kid, okay, be mindful of the people you hang around. And when you get to a point where you're not ashamed to hang around certain people and to do certain things, I just think it instills a sense of community in our kids, right? And what happens is, they start to hang around people who are more like them on a positive note. They start to find positive things. Even when there's mm-hmm. nothing positive going on, they start to find positive things. And then now they have a group of friends who encourage them in a positive way. It is just a funny thing. When my son, I'll use my son for instance. My son came to me. And I'll never forget, I think he was a junior or senior in high school, And he says to me, "Well, Dad, I don't want to play sports anymore." I think it was a sophomore, junior. "I don't want to play sports anymore." "Okay. Well, I want to act and I want to dance." I'm like, "Okay." And then later on, his senior year for certain, he said, "Dad, I want to be a dancer. I don't want to do all this stuff." And I was like, I didn't know how to take it, right, because my own stereotypes in my head. But I did know I needed to respond in a positive manner. And my response to him was, I gave him a big hug, and I said, "Well, great. Why didn't you tell me before?" I asked him, "Why didn't you tell me before? That way I can support you in what you do. I mean, I want to be there. You know, you got recitals and you got these plays you're acting in. I never get an invite, right?" And he didn't even know it, but I kind of felt a little low. Well, I tell you what, I don't know if this changed his trajectory or not, but I offered to get him because I asked him if he needed anything. He said some shoes. I got him the shoes. My son's now, he just turned 24, and he's still chasing that dream to be a dancer. He hasn't quit. He hasn't given up. He ain't slack up on it. He's posting all these videos on YouTube and Instagram. You know, he loves it. That's his crowd. And if it doesn't make him better at what he's trying to do, to hone his craft, he's out of it. He's like, he doesn't spend a lot of time with it. And I think my support for him is on the one thing. Another thing I believe that having a sense of pride in who you are and where you're going is he's managed to stay humble. He has managed to stay humble. And I believe that what you guys are talking about, I believe that these are the kinds of things that help develop healthy young adults who go on in life to become more and better at things than we ever thought possible, than they ever thought possible. And so, mm-hmm. You know, my son's not braggadocious. He doesn't brag about everything. He doesn't do something for you to praise him or anything. My son is different. He does it because he loves it, and he tries to be the best he can be at. He teaches at a couple of dance schools back home. I mean, like he does all this stuff, and I'm saying pride. You know, so today when I started thinking about what was being said to me and what I was and what I was talking about with this person, I left the conversation feeling like this. I felt that I'm glad that I can walk into, I mean, I'm one of those guys, I can go hang out on the block with you, I can go hang out on the street corner, you know, I can go and hang out in the corporate office, or I can go to a boardroom. You know, for me, it's basically a change in clothes. The demeanor doesn't change. Of course, the verbiage changes a little bit, but I can go from whichever corner, whatever spectrum I'm in. And I think for me, the thing is, I have a sense of pride in all that I do. I'm willing to try new things. Why? Because I have a sense of pride in everything I do, and even in myself. I want to be well-rounded. I want to be more culturally diverse. And I think that today we have to focus on our young people with that. Because and let's not even just talk about young people, because I know a lot of the young men, a lot of brothers I talk, I'm going to say, like, a lot of brothers that I talk to, you know, they need to be guided. We all need to be guided. We need to be ushered into a new era. Terry, you remember that movie? What was that movie you wanted me to watch about those two guys, Samuel L. Jackson? What was that movie? The Banker.
The Banker, yeah.
Jason,
Banker.
Have you seen that movie, The Banker, Jason?
No, I haven't. What's that one about?
Well, I won't even get into the whole gist of the movie because I'm not good at telling you exactly what it's about. But it's about a guy who had a dream, and his dream just got big. He didn't want to be he didn't like being discriminated against when he was a kid. And when he got older, he got into real estate. And when he got into real estate, there were a lot of roadblocks. And he was relentless in his pursuit of his dream. Oh, yeah, I didn't hear that. And so, anyway, he knew his abilities. He knew what he was good at, and he was very good with numbers. And he was very good with doing his research. And so the other guy was really good because he was just a charismatic guy with money and a can-do attitude. Well, I forget the name of the names of the characters. Terry, if you remember them, please let me know. But the one guy, the original guy that the movie was about, he had a sense of pride in who he had become. And his sense of pride in who he had become led him to believe he could do anything, no matter what the obstacle was. So his sense of pride allowed him to venture off into new things. How many of us know kids who are afraid to try new things right now? How many of us who were children, who were kids, young kids, who were afraid to try new things for one reason or another? See, I think that developing a sense of pride in who you are first, right? You know who you are. You say, okay, I can try something new. And then you give yourself permission, you hear that, to be the best you can be, no matter what that new thing is. You give yourself permission. I like to say you give yourself permission to fail. But you also give yourself permission to develop a new and succeed. And so, again, when I'm thinking about pride, I'm going through all these things, right? Sound like some sort of therapist, because I'm not. I just want y'all to know. But and in all of those things that I tried in my life, it led me to another thing, and it led me to do the things that I love. Like my son, he's doing the one thing that he loves, and that's to dance. All because I believe in the beginning he had a sense of pride in who he was. He may have been nervous, he may have been afraid, but he had a sense of pride. And so I think we really have to dig deep. We have to dig deep to find these things. I mean, is there something that you wanted to do, either one of you wanted to do, and you didn't for whatever reason, and one day you tried it? And what made you do that?
Yeah.
What kept you trying to be better at it? What was the motivation?
And honestly, Cedric, I want to answer what you're saying, if you don't mind me jumping in. But I also want to say something to you. What you did with your son by saying, wow, that's awesome, and cheering and allowing him to, you know, and supporting him, that did him more. That allowed him to just really just to breathe and to walk into, you know, that thing. You know what I'm saying? I think one of the things I think as adults that we have a tendency to do, I know that my parents did, they were afraid of some of the things that they didn't understand or didn't go with their way of thinking. And as a result, some of the things that I may have dreamed about got shut down by them with no support because they said, no, that's not something that guys do, or that's not something that
like
da-da-da-da-da. You know, I'm just throwing it out there like that. I can't be specific.
Yeah, but
right,
give me real
offhand.
World. Give me real world.
Oh, real world.
People that don't know you don't know what you're talking about. Just anything.
Yeah. Like men don't dance. You know, I was a big dancer when I was in middle school, and you know, and they said that, and that almost, and it literally almost shut me down. It literally almost shut me down. Because I didn't have their
right.
support. It wasn't something that they did not understand. You know, and I guess, and that's the part that I think that as adults that we need to do is to really to help. One of the ways that we're going to help release and help our young people, our next generation, or even other adults to step out and do some things that they never thought they were able to do is to really break that barrier down and say, you know something, and allow them that room to do and become all that, you know, they were designed to and God ordained for them to be.
Yeah. It's funny you said that. And because I see a lot of young men today, young and old, because an old fool was once a young fool.
That's right.
Yeah, young, spread that if you want. But the reason I bring that point up is I know many a young man who have been afraid. They say they have pride in who they are, and they really didn't. They say they have pride in where they come from, but they really weren't. But what they were proud of is the accomplishment that they had made in life. And unfortunately, a lot of these young men, the accomplishments that they were proud of meant that they went to jail. Yeah, I made a lot of money selling drugs. Yeah, I met these beautiful women, but you had seven or eight of them. You know what I'm saying? You're out doing the wrong thing. It's time to again, apply the pride thing to the positivity, to everything positive in our lives. Not be arrogant, but be proud enough to be who you are so that you can move forward. I'm sorry, Terry, you go around here and finish with what you were saying, because I think what you're saying is true, and we do need to support our children and other adults as well. Uh-huh.
No, you're totally on it. I mean, you are totally on it, sir. As far as that is concerned, I just think that being able to them to understand you got permission, you've got permission. It's okay. You don't need my approval. You don't need nobody's approval. You know what I'm saying? But for what I just think about your son, he wanted your approval because he came to you with that. You know, he wanted daddy's approval. You know, because, you know, I don't know what images or what thoughts may have gone in his mind, but it's one of those type of things where he needed that. I mean, I'm just being honest, as an adult, I struggled with that a lot. And it was, and honestly, I'm just being honest, straight up, it was like with you even. I even struggled with that with you in our friendship and because I've seen how you know, how your stance is on certain things, and I'm like, well, if I do this or say that, then he's not, you know, it's not going to meet his approval, and blah, 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 blah. And that kept me from doing some things or even saying some things because of that, you know? And I think again, it's being able to help our fellow brothers, our next generation as well, to understand that, hey, you know something, you don't need my approval. You don't need the next man's approval. But only one you need approval from is God. If God is placed it on your heart, if God is moved in you to do those things, then you do it. You do it. You be it.
See, I agree with that. But since I'm talking about that, I think you've you're using the example of my wife. I think since we're talking about the positive side. I'm saying that if you see someone, you know, if you see someone and they're trying something new, they stepped outside of their comfort zone and they're trying to do something that's completely outside of themselves, because I'm going to encourage the two of you to continue to do it as well as I can encourage myself. Is that, have a good word for them. Have a positive word for them. You know, here's a real example. Most of my friends will tell you I'm horrible at this, but I don't really mean anything bad. I will generally, people who are close to me, when I greet them, a lot of times it's with an insult, right? No, I don't mean it to be negative, but I found that some of my friends, it's quite negative. And I try to change that pattern of behavior. Like I have this one friend, I call him Chubby. And I know he don't like being called Chubby because he's kind of self-conscious about his weight, right? But I constantly do it. And, you know, in my reflection today, in all of my self-reflection, that's one of the things I said, you know what? That's got to change. That's got to change. Why? Because I want this person, this brother, to have a sense of pride in who he is. Again, not be arrogant. And, you know, I'll tell you, I don't believe in coddling adults, but I do believe in giving them a hug. I do believe in walking with them through whatever struggle they may be going through. You hear me? If it means a pat on the back, if I got to hold your hand through this whole thing because this situation is so traumatic, I want you to understand. And here it is. And this is basically the point I wanted to bring it all to for me is, you know, we have to have a sense of pride in who we are as men, especially black men. We have to have a sense of pride in our community, and we also have to have a sense of pride in our past. Here it is, because our past is going to lead us to our future, okay? So we have to have a sense of pride in where we are going in this life. It's okay to feel like you've accomplished something in your life. It's okay to feel accomplished. It's okay to understand and know that you have an ability, right? It's not okay to be arrogant about it, but it's okay to have a good feeling about your abilities, right? Again, I'm not talking about bragging and always jumping out in front of people. No. It's okay, though,
to know and understand this. Because there's nothing wrong in believing in who you are. Has either of you ever gone through a situation where you thought, wow, well, Terry, you just brought up one of yours. Well, I'm a good dancer. I love dancing. And your parents said, well, little boys don't dance like that. Don't dance. I tell you, that I think that that was one of the better things that my parents did for me growing up, is they always told me, son, you can be whatever you put your mind to. Now, I will tell you on the flip side, man, that could be detrimental to a child because it's overwhelming, right? I wanted to be so many things. But I think it's okay for us to feel accomplished as long as this feeling is grounded. And for us, we're all three Christian brothers. For anybody who ever listens to this who may not be Christian or who may not be have any religious affiliation, I say stay grounded. Stay grounded, stay humble, but know that it's okay to embrace who you are and what you hope to become. And that's just that's how I thought about this topic all day today. Wasn't for sure I even wanted to talk about it at all, but I think it's important that we all grasp hold of this thing, because too many of us are walking around thinking we got to be perfect. If I'm not great at this thing, then nobody's gonna want to do it. Well, guess what? I'm not great at podcast hosting. All right, I'm gonna learn every week. Okay, and some of the things I don't have to learn 8 weeks in a row. But I'm going to learn it. I'm going to read the books. Whatever it takes is what I'm going to put forth. And one of the reasons I'm so motivated, one of the reasons why relentless pursuit means so much to me is because I take pride in my work, right? No matter how small or how large the task may be, care about it. I care about me enough to give it my best. And that's me in a nutshell. I know we're going to close out in just a few minutes, guys, so I want to give you a chance to, if you got some last-minute statements, if you want to leave us with parting words, words of encouragement, even if you have a testimony, how it's worked for you. I'll open the floor. Jason, you've been the quietest the longest.
So, no, just to kind of just keep piggybacking off what you said, I think, you know, to believe in yourself and to internalize that, and to, you know, just to know you're somebody. I think everybody, you know, should operate in that capacity.
Yeah. And have you had an experience with that where it really paid off for you in the end, or?
Yeah, you know, I would tell you just you know, growing up, I was like, you know, I wasn't the most popular, wasn't the most athletic, and when I got to college, you know, I finally, you know, just decided, like, actually, I take that back. It was in high school, and I started working. And like you said, when you involve yourself in something and people see something different in you, and I was able to, you know, advance my career pretty rapidly. And it just, I don't know, it did something for me. It did something to say, you know what, you are somebody. And then it forced me to now stand up and be and continue to be that person. So, no, I'll tell you, a little pride is not a bad thing.
Yeah, and you know, and most of the time we talk to young people about it or our peers about it, I think we're talking about the extreme negative side and that extreme negativity. But you said something, Jason. You said you were able to advance your career. Did you say you went to college and then you advanced your career? I didn't hear the part before that.
No, that was in high school. And that's what I'm telling you. It was randomly in high school, and I was working at Six Flags of all the places.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, that's the things that were internal to me, like, you know, that sense of my mom taught me work ethic. She taught me integrity. She taught me all these things. And, you know, like we always see in high school, those are not the cool kids, right? It's not the kid who always tells the truth that's the cool kid. It's not the kid who respects women that's the cool kid, you know? So you can walk around feeling like, you know what? And, you know, you can challenge that identity because your environment tells you something different. But when I got into an environment in which those values that were instilled in core to me, we got rewarded, it just reinforced them. And then, like, in, to your point, I think a lot of kids have these values put in, they internalize these values, but then they get in environments where the things they have internalized don't really provide any type of success for them. They get ridiculed. They get made fun of. They get all the negativity that comes from it. So a lot of kids just say, you know what, screw it. I'm just going to be like everybody else. Right? So, Terry, to your point, when you find that kid that's great in something and to help them know the things that inside you are great and to feed into that, it does wonders for children, right? It does wonders for them. You know, they can now take that and they'll go beyond just, you know, the things that they do, but the things they believe in too. So I think it's important to always encourage a kid. And what you did with your son I think was amazing, you know, because, yeah, it was an action, but I think it also helps them reinforce, like, you know what, I do believe, you know, I know I'm a good dancer, but you know what, I think I'm a good person too. And that reinforcement, you know, once you start that reinforcement process, it just can just blossom and burn like a wildfire.
Amen. Wow, that is awesome. Now, do you share that with your students sometimes?
I do. You know, not as much as I used to, but now that I think about it, you know, like just being on this phone call just kind of helped me thought about like how that one part of my life really shifted and kind of changed some things. So, you know, I don't share it as much, but I'll definitely make sure I share it more often.
Awesome. Terry, did you have anything you want to share with us?
I know you do.
No, I think I know you
got some wonderful praise. Jason did a great job.
Jason got it, man. He hit it right on the head.
Well, I did. You know, because I just truly, I believe that this is really important. This is something that, I feel like I was very fortunate the way that I grew up. We didn't have a lot of money. So I didn't get to go a lot of places. I didn't get to do a lot of things. But we did have a foundation. Our family was foundational. And my parents truly loved showing other people that they cared. They didn't have to know them, but they just – and it wasn't something they did, you know, so, oh, look at me, I'm doing this. No, it was we didn't have much, but what I have, you're welcome to. You know, when you become a part of this family, and then when you became a part of the family, I saw my parents treat other adults and children the same way they treated us, you know. And my dad took great pride in being a provider, the type of provider he was. My mom took great pride in being the type of wife and mother and caregiver that she was. Everybody took pride in it. And then so they taught us, you know, again, don't be arrogant. Don't go over the top, but be proud of who you are. Respect yourself, and other people will respect you too. And I think that that is a that's something that in this world we live in right now, pride is not hate. Okay, pride in who you are doesn't mean that you hate another person. Pride in who you are is not that. And I'm glad that I was instilled with some of these healthy values, especially when it comes to pride, at a very young age, and it stayed with me. And throughout my military career, if something bad happened, people say, well, he still takes great pride in taking care of himself. It wasn't about being arrogant, boisterous. I wasn't trying to cause attention. I just took extra care to make sure that I was ready for whatever came my way. And so with that being said, you know, I just really want to let everybody know, you know, this is always fun. This is always great. But I want people to grow. I want people to grow. I want people to be who you are. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to try something new. Don't be afraid to try to be the best that you can be. You know, life is not about competition. Sometimes we can get being competitive mixed up with pride. Now, being competitive is just that. You're competing. I tell people all the time, look, don't compete against me in anything. Why? Because I'm not going to compete against you. All right? I'm gonna compete against me, and I'm gonna move forward. Now, there's some sports that we play, we have to compete against other people, but even in those sports, I tell people, be better tomorrow than you were yesterday. Be better tomorrow than you are today, and so on and so forth. And so these are the things that I want people to take with them. I want you to walk out in life and say, it's okay, but I take pride in my appearance. You know, the saggy jeans. I'm not a big fan of tattoos. Being a soldier for as long as I was, I don't have tattoos. Tattoos aren't my thing. But take pride in who you are. And you can look, you can have a bunch of tattoos, you can even wear saggy jeans, but still take pride in who you are and how you treat the community. So I'm going to close out here. Sister Kim, you can go ahead and cue up our music. I want to thank you, Terry and Jason, for being on tonight. And we're looking forward to doing this again this time next week. So with that being said, y'all know how we do it this time. Find something you love. You embrace it. And by embrace, I mean you take pride in the fact that this is what I love to do, and you start to move into things that are right, and then you're going to chase it. And as you're chasing this dream, man, you take pride in this is where I'm going, this is where I've been, this is what led me to here, and that is your relentless pursuit. It will never go away. God love you. God bless you. And we out. Have a good weekend, everybody.
Lord, I just want to say thank you for sending your son down to die for my sins. Even though I messed up, did I get it wrong? You love me unconditionally. So here I am, all I have is you, a sinner saved by grace, but is that really true? Cause I'm still feeling love for what I used to do. And I don't feel a change, but my heart yearns for you. I don't feel complete, even when it's going right. When I'm missing you, Lord, please come into my life. Loving you the real test, not to love you to get blessed. And yes, I know that you the best. So here I am to worship, sacrifice my life so you can work it. How you see fit for your glory is worth it. Everything else can take a backseat. Running to your throne for your mercy like a track meet. Why you have to ask me? I don't understand. Without you, Lord, how can I be a real man? I ain't gonna try. I give you all of me, Lord, and ride till I die. Put my knees to the floor.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely. Altogether.
Me still to this day, it feel make believe. Why would you save me? I stoned you to death, I made you bleed on your cross to your last breath. Lord, was I really worth it? Cause apart from you, my life is all worthless. Ain't no point in working, cause it's all in vain. Without a real purpose, I really need to change. I don't know how, it's amazing that you even called me. Lord, I'm in awe, see my struggle still haunt me. Random women every night, just to feel wanted. To feel like a man, cause my daddy didn't want me. Had a past pain, addicted to Mary Jane. Father on cocaine, money down the drain. Baby mama drama, got me going insane. I know I've been redeemed, but
here
I don't feel
I
a change.
Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to
I'm paying homage to your father, that's my only option. After you ripped the veil and gave me the gospel, so I could see the truth, so I can walk with you. And that's the greatest thing that anyone can ever do. You really saved my life when I was worse at it. An addict on any level for pleasure, pain, and passion. I could never grasp it, cause it's never lasting. But Lord, you everlasting. I burn my flesh to ashes so I can walk with you. Your love is unconditional. So even though I struggle with my past, you still see me through. Sometimes I get it wrong, I fail plenty times, but I get back up and I ride your son, live and die for my eternal life. So now I'm still tight. God inside, you give me light. Now I'm saying I will fight all my pain, hurt, and my struggles in my past life. Lord, you wipe away my tears every night.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to sing.